Hello friends, welcome to EC Academy. In this lecture, let us understand Mason's gain formula. In block diagram reduction, we use the block diagram reduction rules to obtain the overall transfer function. If we consider the signal flow graph, we can use the formula to find the overall transfer function. This formula is known as Mason's gain formula. Mason's gain formula states that overall transfer function is equal to summation of Tk into delta k divided by delta. Here k represents number of forward path, Tk is gain of kth forward path, delta is equal to 1 minus sum of individual loop gain plus sum of product of non-touching loop gain taken two at a time minus sum of product of non-touching loop gains taken three at a time plus and so on. In this formula, sum of individual loop gain is nothing but we take individual loop and we'll calculate the loop gain and we'll substitute in this place. Sum of product of non-touching loop gain taken at two at a time means we'll consider two non-touching loops in a given signal flow graph. We'll take the product of two non-touching loop at a time and we'll find the sum of those non-touching loops. Then we'll see how many three non-touching loops are there. We'll take the product of those three non-touching loops and then we'll take the sum of product which we have taken for three non-touching loops. Delta k is equal to 1 minus loop gain which does not touch the forward path. We'll identify the non-touching loops for the forward path and then we'll take the loop gain and we'll substitute here in this formula. All these things you will understand if you consider an example. Now let us consider this signal flow graph as an example. For this signal flow graph, let us apply Mason's gain formula. The first step is to find the number of forward path. In a signal flow graph, forward path is nothing but reaching from input to the output without crossing any node more than once. So you need to reach from input to output without crossing any node more than once. So if you observe this signal flow graph, this is one forward path and this is second forward path. So we are reaching from input to output without crossing any node more than once. The number of forward path k is nothing but 2. So the Mason's gain formula overall transfer function will reduce to, since k is equal to 2, we can take t1 delta 1 plus t2 delta 2 divided by delta. If we get k is equal to 3, we will write this formula as t1 delta 1 plus t2 delta 2 plus t3 delta 3 divided by delta. Now we need to find t1, t2, delta 1, delta 2 and delta, and we need to find the overall transfer function. T1 is the first forward path, which is 1 into g1 into g2 into g3 into g4, which is nothing but g1, g2, g3, g4. This is the first forward path. The second forward path is 1 into g5 into g4. So we get t2 is equal to g5 into g4. Now let us find the individual feedback loop gains. Loop is nothing but a path that originates at one node and terminates at the same node. In this signal flow graph, you can see we are having a loop here. So it is originating at this node and it is terminating at the same node. So we can call that as first loop. L1 is equal to G2 into minus H1. So it is minus G2 H1. We have second loop here, which is G1, G2, G3, G4 into minus H2. So we can take second loop. The overall gain will be minus G1, G2, G3, G4, H2. And we have third loop, which is originating from this node, which is G5, G4 into minus H2, and it is terminating at the same node. So third loop, which is equal to G5, G4 into minus H2. So we can write that as minus H2. So L3 is equal to minus G5, G4, H2. Next, we need to find non-touching loop pairs. So we will take two non-touching loops. If you observe this loop, L1 and L3, these two loops are non-touching loops. So we can say L1 and L3 are non-touching loops. So we can take L1 into L3. So the overall gain will be equal to minus G2H1 multiplied with minus G5G4H2. So this is nothing but G2G4G5H1H2. So we got two non-touching loop pair whose loop gain is G2, G4, G5, H1, H2. We don't have any other two non-touching loops in this signal flow graph. Now, if we want to find three non-touching loops, we don't have any three non-touching loops here. Now, let us find delta. Delta is equal to 1 minus sum of individual loop gains. So sum of individual loop gains is minus G2H1, minus G1, G2, G3, G4, H2, minus G5, G4, H2. We need to add all these loop gains. So it is minus G2H1, minus G1, G2, G3, G4, H2, minus G5, G4, H2, plus sum of product of non-touching loop taken two at a time. We already found that product of two non-touching loops. So we can write that G2, G4, G5, H1, H2. So delta will be equal to 1. If you multiply this minus sign, we'll get plus G2H1 plus G1, G2, G3, G4 H2 plus G5 G4 H2 plus G2 G4 G5 H1 H2. So this is delta. Let us find delta 1. For forward path T1, all the loops are touching. We can write delta 1 is equal to 1 minus 0. So from this we can say delta 1 is equal to 1. Now let us find delta 2. So delta 2 is with respect to T2. If we take second path T2, this loop which does not touch the forward path, this is the overall loop gain that does not touch the forward path T2. So that's why we can write delta 2 is equal to 1 minus of minus G2H1. So which is we have taken from loop 1. So delta 2 is nothing but 1 plus G2H1. This is delta 2. So we found all the parameters in the formula. We found T1, T2. We found delta 1, delta 2 and delta. So let us substitute. So overall transfer function C of S divided by R of S for the given signal flow graph can be written as, so we need to write T1. So it is G1, G2, G3, G4. Delta 1 is 1. So this term multiplied with 1 will be the same term, plus T2. It is G5, G4. Into delta 2, which is 1 plus G2H1 whole divided by delta. So delta is 1 plus g2 h1 plus g1 g2 g3 g4 h2 plus g5 g4 h2 plus g2 g4 g5 h1 h2. So this is the overall transfer function of the given signal flow graph by using Mason's gain formula. Hope you have understood the topic. Thank you.